Welcome back. We are now here with Lisa Gerard, our dog training expert with BarkBusters, to talk to us about some tips about playing indoors with your dog if you can't get outside because of this nasty weather that we're having.
Right. This is the time of year when the days are short, the weather's kind of yucky. Most people are not likely to go out and walk their dog. Mm-hmm. So you want to think of things that you can do inside to still have some activity and interaction and play and fun. Most people, when they think of playing with their dogs, they think about tossing the ball.
Right.
Or the frisbee, or squeaky toys. And some dogs like those things, but that's not for every dog. So some dogs prefer different ways of play, such as you might play a game called Keep Away. It involves a couple people, but you take an item uh-huh. that the dog really wants,
okay.
and you maybe toss it back and forth uh-huh. across a room.
Okay.
She's not real interested
in She's not participating in this, but that's okay.
And then inadvertently, oops, you drop it one time, so uh-huh. the dog gets it, and they get to have some fun. So there's a lot of chasing back and forth, and interaction with you is the key. They want to spend time with you. Some other things that dogs enjoy, you could chase. You could chase them, they could chase you around the house, and a lot of dogs really enjoy that kind of thing.
What about going around? I know I've played with dogs before. Mm-hmm. Going around in a circle, running around in a circle,
sure.
is that okay?
Or? Absolutely. Okay. You always want to just be aware, is the dog getting too wound up? Do mm-hmm. you have a dog that starts to nip and get a little bit too excited? Then you want to call it off. So just kind of be aware of the tone of the play.
Certainly.
And if it's getting to be too much. One thing you can do, if you have a dog that's really good with sit-stay, you can play hide-and-seek. So
wow.
I'll put all my dogs in a sit-stay, and I'll go hide somewhere else in the house. And then I'll release them, and they have to come and find me. They have to use all their senses to
really?
Figure out where I am. They love that stuff.
Do they usually give up after a while if they
no,
can't find you?
No.
So they'll keep going until they find you.
They'll keep going until they find me. One of them is better than the other, so the others kind of follow along and cheat. But they still have a great time, and that's the key.
Right on.
Then if you have a dog that's a little bit more sedentary, lower energy, you might want to use some things like puzzle toys that gets them involved mm-hmm. mentally, but they don't have to do a lot of strenuous activity. Puzzle toys, you just stuff them with treats or
okay.
different types of food, and then the dog has to figure out how to get those things out. And so it takes them time, it takes them some mental energy, and they have a good time. A Buster Cube is another example of that. You put their dry food in there, and then they have to nose it along the floor and figure out how to get those treats to fall out. So those are just some examples.
Can they fit inside, or can their mouths fit inside these?
No, you just dump the dry food in here,
they just
distribute
knock it, around.
It, and every once in a while, as they're rolling it around, a little bit falls out.
Gotcha.
So,
excellent.
That type of thing.
Well, thanks so much, Lisa. I really appreciate your time. If you want more information on this, you can go to our website, kvtv.com. We've got links there for BarkBusters if you want to check out more information. So, Lisa, thank you so much.
Thank you.
When we come back, Jason Valentine will have a look at sports. Stay with us.